After the season, I had like I had some offers from Adriatic League that I played for many, many years, and it was good offers. I cannot say nothing about them, but I had like I think the most important thing in life is to know what you want, and in this way, I wanted to play outside the, let me say, the ex-Yugoslavia and from Adriatic League to spend as many years or I don't know how much as I can playing outside. It's maybe a couple of times I saw the interview with Marco Spi and he was Spisu and he was saying that it's different for Italians to play outside Italy. For me, it's like the same. I had like really good time in Dinamo last year with really good group of guys. I enjoy. I remember on one of our last interviews, I said this is like the best group of guys I ever been around because we had like even off the court, mostly off the court, we had amazing time together. We enjoy spending time together and we became really good friends, everybody. So I wanted to experience that again in foreign countries, and that's why I didn't want to sign back in Adriatic League. And now this opportunity came for me, and this was like really one of the easiest decisions in my career. I'm coming back to the place that I spent one amazing year with everybody, not just with group of guys, with people around the club. I think I have really good relationship with everybody, and I'm looking forward to coming back. I know the situation is not ideal, but okay, this is the situation in sport. You know, sometimes the season goes up, sometimes it goes down, but hopefully we can turn the cycle and change the things around the club.
Sì, ecco, Krule diceva proprio in questa sua prima risposta del fatto che quest'estate ha avuto delle offerte dalla Lega Adriatica, è stato in ballo anche per ritornare alla Dinamo, poi lui il suo grande desiderio era quello di giocare fuori dalla ex Jugoslavia, di riuscire, come anche gli ha detto Marco Spisso in tante volte che si sono sentiti, di riuscire ad uscire dalla propria comfort zone, dal proprio campionato. Lui ha aspettato, è rimasto ovviamente 2 mesi aspettando questa situazione, e poi la decisione più facile per lui è stata quella di accettare la proposta della Dinamo, di ritornare alla Dinamo, anche se in una situazione non idilliaca al momento, però le stagioni, come dice lui, in alcuni momenti vanno bene, in alcuni momenti vanno male, però sono arrivo per cercare di girare l'inerzia di questa stagione, perché io ho sempre trovato comunque un gruppo di ragazzi, un gruppo, un ambiente, una società che è straordinaria, che è stata straordinaria per me, per la mia famiglia, quindi è stata la più facile delle decisioni quella di tornare alla Dinamo. I ask you, Krule, if you talk with the coach, with Freddy, what they ask you about your role in the team?
I talked with Fed a couple of hours ago, but just like a short talk about me signing back. I didn't yet talk with the coach, but we have time, we'll talk. But in any case, I watched probably not all games, but I mean, of Dinamo this season, I watched all games, but Italian League, I watched like 80% of the games. So, so everybody knows me, what I can bring. I know what I have to do, and I think we will find solution very quickly. I'm not a difficult guy to talk with.
Gli abbiamo chiesto se aveva già parlato col coach o con Federico. Ho parlato con Federico questa mattina e ieri sera per quanto riguarda la firma del contratto, però ovviamente sa quello che deve fare, sa l'ambiente dove arriva, conosce il campionato italiano, ha visto tante partite, ci sarà tempo per parlare con il coach ovviamente, però il suo desiderio è quello di mettersi subito a disposizione della Dinamo. Last question, what do you think need this team to turn the season what you said before?
It's always the same in sports, in basketball, you know. When you play good, you have to practice good, everything, because you need like just a couple of bad, I can say a couple of bad practices, couple of bad minutes, and easily the things turn the wrong way, you know. And this is the situation even in even when teams don't play good, when they lose games. Usually you don't need a lot to turn the table and start winning games. So the solution is in 90% of the times the solution is not like too complicated. You know, you just need to enjoy first practicing, enjoy spending time together, try to execute everything that the coaching staff and the coach ask from you, and I think if we do these little small things, because small things change the whole perspective. So I think it's just like really small things, and then everything can turn in our way. You had like a couple of difficult games. The last game I watched in against Tortona. So I think we will start to win. It's just a matter of time.
Sì, ha detto che praticamente la differenza tra l'andare male a volte e l'andare bene, magari qualche allenamento, qualche partita che gira storto, il filo è sottile, basta poco, basta divertirsi, basta lavorare nella maniera giusta, basta girare le cose che poi di un tratto tutto può andare bene. Lui ha visto anche, come avete sentito a fine della sua risposta, ha visto anche la partita di Tortona, però pensa che le cose possano cambiare, e ovviamente è venuto per cercare di dare una grossa mano, di mettersi a disposizione di quello che il coach, lo staff gli chiederanno di fare all'interno della squadra. Last things, Krule, one message for the fans, for people in Sardinia. You know that now maybe we hope that the fans stay in the gym, can arrive to the 100% to watch the game at the Palace. This is very important because you know that we played in one season that people are outside the gym.
Yeah, I agree. When I talked with everybody that spent a lot of years in Dinamo, of course, my biggest regret of the last season is that we didn't play in front of fans, because a couple of times Miro showed me clips from the fans in the gym, and it was like really amazing. So to play in front of empty gym, and you know which kind of fans you got, it's a little bit disappointing. It was like my biggest regret from last season. But hopefully, I don't know the situation right now with the regulations and everything. Hopefully now I saw some people on the game. I don't know in which kind of percent they are on the stands, but I hope that till very soon they can come in 100%, and I can feel the crowd and the energy that I missed last year. And nothing, the message is just Forza Dinamo.
Il messaggio ovviamente l'avete sentito è Forza Dinamo, però gli abbiamo chiesto appunto se il fatto di avere i tifosi adesso rispetto alla passata stagione quando non aveva, gli ho detto Miro Bilan mi aveva fatto vedere tante volte i filmati del tifo del palazzetto pieno, e questa è una grande cosa, ci può dare una grande spinta sicuramente. speriamo che possano arrivare presto al 100%, non è un momento facile, però è bellissimo giocare con i tifosi, e dunque forza Dinamo, and, forza Dinamo.